I want to go over some common issues that might arise when working with VirtualBox. The first issue I want to talk about is antivirus software. Some Windows antivirus software, such as Avira, AVG, and others, have been known to interfere with the operation of VirtualBox. I've listed some errors on your screen here that can be associated with this type of issue. If you get such an error when starting a virtual machine, try disabling your antivirus software and rebooting your system. Here's a screenshot of one such error. Again, the workaround for this is to simply disable the antivirus software or switch to another antivirus software that doesn't interfere with VirtualBox. If you happen to have a Mac, you could use it for your coursework, as most of the issues we'll be talking about here are Windows related in some way. If you see an error in your virtual machine window that says something along the lines of "this kernel requires an x86-64 CPU, but only detected an i686 CPU, then you need to enable the virtualization options in your BIOS. This means making sure that you have VTX for Intel processors and AMDV for AMD processors enabled. This varies from manufacturer to manufacturer, so you might have to look up the documentation for your specific computer. Another thing that can cause the "this kernel requires an x86-64 CPU" message can be that you've selected a 32-bit processor in VirtualBox itself. In this case, the error message really isn't talking about your physical processor, but the virtual processor that it sees. Go into the settings of the virtual machine you're having an issue with, and make sure you've selected a 64-bit version for whatever Linux distribution you're using. For example, if you're using CentOS, select Red Hat 64-bit, because CentOS really is Red Hat, just without the branding. If you're using Ubuntu, make sure you select Ubuntu 64-bit, etc. Finally, I want to leave you with one last troubleshooting step, which is to simply reboot your physical computer and try again. There's a chance that something is not functioning properly that isn't immediately obvious to us. When it comes to troubleshooting our local systems, this is a relatively quick and harmless thing to try.